Welcome to Maker's Pet first time setup instructions video. In this video, I will set up a Windows PC to run Maker's Pet home robots and upload Arduino firmware to the robot's microcontroller. Once finished, this home robot will act as a pet, look cute, play ball, hide and seek and chase, entertain the owner, keep company, demand attention, and patrol the house. Let's start by installing Arduino software on your Windows computer. Open your browser and search for Arduino IDE download. Once on the Arduino software download page, scroll down to Legacy IDE and click Windows download on the right. Open the downloaded Arduino Windows executable file and follow the installation prompts. Let's launch the Arduino IDE and add support for ESP32 microcontrollers. Open the File Preferences dialog, type this link into the Additional Boards Manager URLs text box and close the dialog. Go to the Tool Board menu and click on the Boards Manager. Type ESP32 in the search text box. Go to the ESP32 board by Espressif Systems, select version 2011 and click Install. Great, you have installed the required board software. Go to Tools, Manage Libraries. There are three libraries to be installed. First, search for KiCAD and install the MicroROS KiCAD library version 207-iron.1. Always use the latest version available. This library enables the robot's microcontroller to talk to the PC over Wi-Fi. Next, search for PID timed and install the latest version of the PID timed library. This library ensures that motors operate at the desired speed. Lastly, search for the ESP Async Web SRV library and install the latest version. This library sets up a tiny web server in the robot's microcontroller. Click Install All to install the required dependencies. We will use this web server to have the robot connect to the home Wi-Fi network. Great, you have installed the necessary libraries. Open your browser once again and navigate to the GitHub repository where we will download an Arduino IDE extension plugin. This plugin will let us upload web page files used by the tiny web server. Click on the link to the zip file. Open the zip file once the download completes and drag the ESP32FS folder to your desktop. Close the zip file folder and your browser. Open the File Explorer folder on your desktop and navigate to your Arduino folder under OneDrive Documents Arduino, not the other documents folder. Once inside the Arduino folder, create a new folder named Tools and move the ESP32FS folder from your desktop into the newly created Tools folder. Let's close and relaunch Arduino to load the newly installed plugin. Go to Arduino Tools and you should see a new menu item named ESP32 Sketch Data Upload. Next, let's download the robot firmware source code. Reopen your browser and navigate to Maker's Pet GitHub repository for the desired robot model. On the repository page, click the green code button and choose download zip. Currently, there are three robot models, Loki, Fido, and Snoopy. Loki is the smaller sized model. You can 3D print it on smaller 3D printers. Fido is medium sized and Snoopy is the largest one. Once the download completes, open the zip file, navigate inside the top folder and inside the Arduino folder. Drag your ESP32 folder to your desktop and close the window with the zip file. This folder contains the ESP32 firmware for the robot model of your choice. Open the File Explorer window again and navigate to the Arduino folder under OneDrive Documents Arduino. Move the ESP32 firmware folder from your desktop into the Arduino folder and close the File Explorer window. Go to Arduino File Open menu, navigate inside the ESP32 robot firmware folder and open the sketch file. Next, go to Tools, Board, ESP32 Arduino and select ESP32 Dev Module. Leave the board settings at their default values. Click on the checkmark button to compile the sketch. The compilation process may take a few minutes. Please be patient and wait for the build to complete. I am fast forwarding the compilation process in this video to save your time. Great, the build process has completed successfully. Let's close Arduino and install the rest of necessary software. As a reference, here is an example of a Windows PC laptop that successfully installs and runs the requisite software. First, let's install Docker prerequisite software called Windows Subsystem for Linux version 2. Open a Windows shell, type wsl-install --no-distribution. Press Enter and follow the Windows prompts. Reboot your computer when prompted. Once your computer reboots, open your browser and search for Docker for Windows download. Open the download page and click the blue Docker Desktop for Windows button to start the download. Simply speaking, Docker will allow us to install and run a large collection of robotic software on your computer in one go. This makes the installation process remarkably simple, relatively speaking. Open the executable file once the download completes and follow the installation prompts. I am fast forwarding this part of the video because the installation process can take a few minutes. Click the blue Close and Restart button to reboot your computer and complete the Docker installation. Let's install an Xserver for Windows. This software will make graphics windows from Linux programs, those running inside Docker, show up right on our Windows machine. Go to the download page of a SourceForge project named VCXSRV. Click the green download button, open the downloaded executable file and follow the installation prompts. Lastly, let's download the robot software that will run inside Docker. Launch Docker, accept the license and follow the prompts. Docker is free for personal use. Close the Docker window. Docker will continue running in the Windows taskbar. Open a Windows shell prompt. Type the Docker pull command and press Enter. This command will download a copy, or using professional terminology, an image of the software that we need. The downloaded image contains robot operating system version 2 pre-configured for MakerSpad robot models. Congratulations, your one-time computer setup is complete. All that remains is to upload the robot firmware to the robot's microcontroller. Launch Arduino and connect your robot's board to your computer using a USB cable. The robot board in the video is a breadboard. I will replace it shortly with a proper custom designed open source PCB. Once the USB cable is connected, go to Arduino Tools and select the serial port. Go to the Tools menu again and click ESP32 Sketch Data Upload. Press and hold for around 2 seconds the button labeled Boot on your ESP32 board. Release the button and wait for the sketch data upload to complete. If the timing of your button press is off, Arduino will print an error message. If that happens, click the ESP32 sketch data upload menu item again and retry the upload. Next, click the Arduino arrow button to compile and upload the firmware. Once the build succeeds, you should see the text in red saying connecting, followed by running dots. At this time, press and hold for 2 seconds the boot button on your ESP32 board and wait for the download to complete. Again, If you press or release the button too early or too late, Arduino will show an error message. If that happens, click the Arduino arrow button and retry the upload once again. Excellent! You have uploaded the firmware to your robot's microcontroller. Disconnect your USB cable from the board and install the board into your robot. Plug both motor cables and the laser distance sensor cable into the board